You've meticulously filled out the application form, put the finishing touches on your impeccable research proposal, and you're almost ready to send off your PhD application. But there's still one more task to do, the dreaded letter of motivation. It's a daunting task, which is probably why you're watching this video right now. A motivation letter has to be both professional and personal, filled with detail yet concise. How do you get the right tone? What do you need to include? And what should you avoid doing? This video is here to help guide you through the process of writing your motivation letter for a PhD in economics, although our advice applies for adjacent disciplines too. After watching this video, be sure to check out our full sample motivation letter for your economics PhD application on enomics.com. A link can be found in the description to this video. Okay, so what do you need to include? Essentially, this letter describes why you want to undertake a PhD and why you would be well suited researching your proposed topic. First, make sure you clearly state which program you've applied for and why you want to join that program specifically. Sounds obvious, right? But you'd be surprised how many people forget this. Second, state why your research matters and what gaps in the current literature or research you'll be addressing. Make sure you don't just describe your research proposal again. They already have that. Instead, explicitly state what motivates you to do this research now. Third, briefly detail your academic background, including any academic achievements or awards you may have attained aside from your degrees. Explain what has led you to applying to a PhD in economics. Finally, briefly explain your future career plans and how your research proposal will help you achieve them. Often, your goal would be to start an academic career, but it doesn't have to be. Just make sure you've explained your motivations in the context of what comes after, and honestly, that's about it. It should be said, this more strictly academically focused structure works best in Europe. In the US, you can discuss other life and work experiences outside of your studies that may be relevant. Nevertheless, you shouldn't give too much personal information. Remember, this is a professional document. So, how do you get the right tone then? Most importantly, remember to be specific and give concrete examples. One bad habit that many people have when writing their motivation letter is being too vague. Don't just say you find economics interesting or you've enjoyed studying it. This is already assumed by the fact that you're applying for a PhD. Mention which particular courses or topics appeal to you most and why would you want to learn more about them. For better results, give concrete examples to your claims in action, such as, "My high level of organization was demonstrated when I successfully organized an undergraduate conference with over 50 attendees." And this brings us to the next point. Make sure you focus on your skills. In a PhD, you will have to come up with your own research questions, choose the best methodology to answer those questions, and motivate and organize yourself to complete the work. If you don't have direct experience with doing these PhD tasks, that's okay. You won't be expected to know everything before you start your PhD. However, you do want to show that you have the capacity to perform this kind of work. Focus on the skills that you have, such as data analysis, writing, research, presentation, and so on. And lastly, you need to strike that tricky balance of remaining professional, but not coming off as a dull, impersonal robot. While your letter should not contain jokes, sarcasm, or irrelevant personal information, if you have a strong opinion about a particular topic in economics, or perhaps you have taken an unconventional career path, describe that. Show how your background gives you a unique perspective. Remember, the point of a motivation letter is not to show how similar you are to an imagined perfect candidate. It's to show off your unique personal approach and how you would be a great PhD student. So, with all that being said, one of the most useful things you can do is look at other motivation letters and personalize accordingly. Head over to the Enomics website, for our example, where you can also search for the latest PhD opportunities in economics. If you found this video useful, be sure to hit like and subscribe so more people can find this video. And good luck writing!